Hello to all friends and loyal followers. I am Arash Adder, and I am here with the continuation of the comprehensive tutorial on Adobe Animate. In this video, we will discuss the bone tool and its features. You should know that any character you want to animate, whether it's a human, an animal, or anything else, must definitely use the bone tool and rigging in order to be animated. Therefore, this lesson is very important, and you must learn it in detail and thoroughly. To access the bone tool, I click on these three dots, and you can see the bone tool here. Its shortcut is the letter M. I click and hold it and actually drag it to this section and release it. Now you can see that the bone tool has appeared. I will select the free transform tool and click on my document to close that window as well. Now, to use the bone tool, we must create a shape. I want to create a basic hand and rig it for animation. So, I come here, right-click, and select the rectangle tool to create a rectangle like this. Using the free transform tool, I select it again and choose a skin color for the human hand. This color is suitable for me. In the stroke section, I select none so that there is no stroke for me. This way, you can now see that there is no stroke either. To give a more natural shape to the hands, I use the selection tool to hold the left click from this corner and drag it to round the edge and create a better shape for me. Now, I want to rig my shape. I must definitely convert it into a symbol. I select it again, right click, and choose Convert to Symbol or press F8. This opens a window where I can choose Movie Clip or Graphic. I select a name for it and press OK. Thus, my shape has been converted to a symbol. I hold down the Alt key and drag it to make a copy of it. To make it easier for friends to see the shape, I click on the document and darken the artboard color a bit. To create a simple palm shape, I use the circle tool. I create this shape for that. A slightly larger size is better. Now, to control the movement of the hand, I create another circle in the same way. It seems to be an appropriate size. I select it and place it here. Now we will also convert these two shapes into symbols. I select them, right-click, choose Convert to Symbol and press OK. Thus, after converting all the shapes into symbols, we select them all. I select the bone tool. Please note that in the layers section, we only have one layer named Layer 1. I click on the area where I want the hand to rotate, that is, the joint, and hold the left click. This way, a joint is created. To create the next joint, I hold the left click and click in the desired area. Thus, we have created one bone and two joints. Now at the wrist, I want to create a rotation. I hold the left click again and place it in the appropriate position and release it. Please note that wherever you create joints, the anchor point of that shape will be placed there. In previous lessons, I taught that rotation causes the shape to rotate from that point. Now, to control the hand, I hold the left click from here, drag it, and place it on the circle so that the entire hand moves with the movement of the circle. Please note that the main bone here is this bone. In fact, the first bone we create is the main or root bone, and the other bones are child bones. This term is given to them because they follow the main bone. Now, as we proceed, it will become more interesting. So just remember that the main bone is always the first bone we create. I will click on my document again to make the color a bit lighter. I go back to the selection tool and click. Now we can see the bones. Friends, if you pay attention to the layer section now, instead of a layer, an armature option has been created that contains all the shapes and bones we created, and we can use this layer to animate our shape. Now, if I move this area with the selection tool, you can see that these bones are moving. By pressing Ctrl plus Z, I revert to the previous state. Now I want to place the shapes back in their original positions. I click here with the free transform tool. Note that when it's selected, I come and place it here. Now I select the palm shape with the free transform tool and place it in this area. This seems suitable. I move it down a bit with the down arrow key on the keyboard. I select the free transform tool again, select this shape, and place it in this area. Now, to create the hand movement again, I'll select the selection tool. And as you can see, our hand is moving and we can animate our hand in this way. But now, friends, to hide this section, let me press Ctrl plus Z to go back to the previous state. To hide this control section, I click on it and go to the Properties panel for the Object and Color effect, which I explained in previous lessons. Here, I select the alpha setting and set the alpha to 0. Note that, since this shape was selected, it has hidden this shape for us. Now, we can easily select the hand. From here, whenever we want to control our shape, we can do it this way. Let's create an animation for our hand. I'll position myself at frame 30 here. I click left to create a keyframe and move my hand using the selection tool like this. Note that this animation has been created for me. Now, I want my shape to return to its original state. In fact, I want to copy this section. I click on this keyframe, select it, right-click, and choose the copy pose option. Pose means gesture. Now, I am copying this pose. Then, I go to frame 0 and select the insert frame option. The frames are created for me. I right-click on the last frame and select the paste pose option. This way, you see that this animation is created for me. In fact, I copied the first frame and now I play it again. Thus, we animated this shape using rigging. Now, friends, I'll select this keyframe and want to give you a brief explanation about these settings so that you are ready to create characters using rigging in future lessons. In the Properties panel, you can see that I selected this form and the text armature has appeared. This method of animating objects using rigging is known as IK. If I want to hide these parts, I can click here and hide them. The joint sections are also here in the color effect, which I explained completely in previous lessons. Since you are familiar with these tools, it's much easier. For example, with this option, we can hide the entire hand. The shape is elongated. However, there's an option called Ease here, which, if you remember, we came to in the graph section to change the speed of the shape's movement. This option is available here for us as well, but in a different form. In the Type section, we can choose the type of movement, such as stop, end, start, fast, medium, and various other modes. Whichever you choose, for example, if I select this and play it, it hasn't made a noticeable change yet. But if I leave it in this state, I will select this keyframe and increase its value. Now I play it and enable the loop option, and it continues looping until the end. Now, see how much the hand movement has changed. There's a step here and then it starts moving again. So, in each section, you can come and select that keyframe and have different options from here. You can select other modes as well and change its value from there. The shape changed again and it has a maximum state and is recreated. We can select it again and choose the none or no ease state for it. In the options, we currently select the simple armature for the animation type. I will discuss another type in future lessons. In the advanced section, we can also choose the type of bone. By default, the bones are solid and we can choose the wireframe mode for them. This mode is important for us, and we use it to see exactly under the shape. It doesn't change anything. The only thing that changes here is the shape of the bone. We can also choose line modes or none, which hides the bone for us. The filter section, which I will teach later as a separate lesson, also has an effect option in the properties and object section. I have taught these before, and I will explain the filters in future tutorials. There is an option called joint, and if I deactivate it, I disable the joint rotation, and these bones won't move anymore. Let me select this bone and disable the joint rotation for it. it won't rotate anymore. Our hand rotates from here, but it won't rotate from here anymore. This is because I selected it with the left click and disabled the joint rotation for this bone using the selection tool. But other bones still rotate. I will select it again and enable this option. I can even determine the rotation amount with the constraint tool here. You see that an angle is created here that I can set for the shape's rotation. Now, in future lessons when we want to animate a character, we will come for all the bones and enable this constraint to restrict the interpreter, which is used for both transition and rotation. We have currently activated this for rotation. I select this bone, and by selecting bones in the location section, it shows us the location of the bone. It shows its fix and displays the rotation value to us. If we rotate it and select it again, you will see that the rotation value is minus 14 degrees, and it shows us that. An important option here is the pin option. If I select the bone and activate the pin option, that bone will no longer move. So, I will select it again and deactivate the pin state. I will deactivate this constraint that is for rotation. I hold the left click and select all frames up to here, then click the remove option. All of them will be deleted for me. Then I create a keyframe and raise the hand. This animation will be created. Another way we can use to create keyframes is to come and hold down the control button on this keyframe and drag it with the left click. For example, until frame 40, I release the left click here. This way, blue frames are created for me. Now, I just need to come and move the hand here. A keyframe is automatically created here, and our animation takes shape. You see that this is how the work is created. Friends, I won't explain more about rigging. Practice and learn this lesson well. In future lessons, we will rig and animate different types of characters. I definitely emphasize watching this lesson several times and practicing until you master it well, as it is the foundation of animation. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to hit the like button, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, subscribe so you don't miss the next video. Goodbye for now.